Welcome to News 9. Now, the attack we hear on techie Nandini in Talagattapura has taken a twist. The police commissioner and the home minister today, in fact, has come out and said that Nandini's attack was not because of her pointing out at illegal cow slaughter, but was a result of road rage. Yes, the home minister spoke to the media today, stating that Nandini could have herself misrepresented with facts.
ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಏನು ಘಟನೆ ಆಗಿದೆಯೋ ಅದರ ಪ್ರಕಾರ ನಿನ್ನೆ ನಮ್ಮ ಪೊಲೀಸ್ ಆಯುಕ್ತರು ಒಂದು ಪ್ರೆಸ್ ಕಾನ್ಫರೆನ್ಸ್ ಮಾಡಿದ್ದಾರೆ. ಏನಿದೆಯೋ ಅದನ್ನು ಹೇಳಿದ್ದಾರೆ ಅಷ್ಟೇ. ಘಟನೆ ತಿರುಚೋ ಅಂತ ಅವಶ್ಯಕತೆ ಪೊಲೀಸ್ ಇಲಾಖೆಯವ್ರಿಗೆ ಏನೂ ಇಲ್ಲ. ಗೋವು ರಕ್ಷಣೆ ಮಾಡಿ ಅಂತ ಒಬ್ಬ ಕಂಪ್ಲೇಂಟ್ ಕೊಟ್ಟಿದ್ದಾರೆ. ಪೊಲೀಸ್ ಅವರು ಹೋಗಿ ಗೋ ರಕ್ಷಣೆ ಮಾಡಿ ವಾಪಸ್ ಕರ್ಕೊಂಬರ್ತಾ ಇದ್ದಾರೆ. ಆ ಸಂದರ್ಭದಲ್ಲಿ ಇವರು ಮತ್ತೆ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಹೋಗಿದ್ದಾರೆ ವಾಪಸ್ಸು. ಪೊಲೀಸ್ ಅವ್ರ ಪ್ರಕಾರ ಇವರೇ ಹೋಗಿ ಒಂದು ಅಂಗಡಿಗೆ ಕಾರಲ್ಲಿ ಇವರೇ ರ್ಯಾಶ್ ಡ್ರೈವಿಂಗ್ ಮಾಡಿ ಯಾರು ಮಾಡಿದ್ರೋ ಇವ್ರು ಮಾಡಿದ್ರೋ ಜೊತೆಲಿ ಇದ್ದರು ಮಾಡೋದಿಲ್ಲ. ರ್ಯಾಶ್ ಡ್ರೈವಿಂಗ್ ಮಾಡಿ ಅದಕ್ಕೆ ಆಕ್ಸಿಡೆಂಟ್ ಆದ ಸಂದರ್ಭದಲ್ಲಿ ಆಕ್ಸಿಡೆಂಟ್ ಆಗಿದ್ದಕ್ಕೆ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಜನ ಗಲಾಟೆ ಮಾಡಿದ್ದಾರೆ ಅಂತ ಪೊಲೀಸರು ಹೇಳಿದರು.
ಈ ಶ್ರೀಮತಿ ನಂದಿನಿ ಎಂಬುವರು ತಮ್ಮ ಇನ್ನೋವ ಕಾರ್ದಲ್ಲಿ ಅವರೇ ಪೊಲೀಸರು ನಾವು ಹೇಳಿದ ಆ ಒಂದು ಏನು ಸಜೆಷನ್ಗೂ ಕೂಡ ಅವರು ಕಿವಿಗೊಡದೆ ಅವರು ಸಹ ತಮ್ಮ ಗಾಡಿಯಲ್ಲಿ ಅವಲಲ್ಲಿಗೆ ತೆರಳಿರುತ್ತಾರೆ. ಆವಲಲ್ಲಿಗೆ ತೆರೆಯುವ ಸಮಯಕ್ಕೆ ಪೊಲೀಸರು ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಮೂರು ಗೋವುಗಳನ್ನು ರಕ್ಷಣೆ ಮಾಡಿಕೊಂಡು ಇನ್ಸ್ಪೆಕ್ಟರ್ ಬೇರೆಂದು ದಾರಿಯಲ್ಲಿ ಠಾಣೆಗೆ ಮರಳುತ್ತಿರುವಾಗ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಆವಲಲ್ಲಿಗೆ ನಂದಿನಿ ಅವರು ಹೋಗಿ ತಮ್ಮ ಇನ್ನೋವಾ ಕಾರ್ದಿಂದ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಒಂದು ಸ್ವಲ್ಪ ಅಪಘಾತವನ್ನು ಮಾಡಿರುತ್ತಾರೆ. ಆ ಅಪಘಾತದಲ್ಲಿ ಒಂದು ನಿಂತಿದ್ದ ಆಟೋಗೆ ಮತ್ತು ಒಂದು ಮಾಂಸದ ಅಂಗಡಿ ಕಂಬಕ್ಕೆ ಡಿಕ್ಕಿ ಹೊಡೆದಿದ್ದರಿಂದ ಅವರ ಕಾರು ಜಖಮಗೊಂಡಿರುತ್ತೆ. ಈ ಅಪಘಾತದಿಂದ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಸೇರಿದ ಜನರು ಈ ಕಲ್ಲು ತೂರಾಟ ಮಾಡಿದ್ದಾರೆ. ಆ ಕಲ್ಲು ತೂರಾಟದಲ್ಲಿ ಅವರಿಗೆ ಸ್ವಲ್ಪ ಸಣ್ಣ ಪುಟ್ಟ ಗಾಯಗಳು ಆಗಿದೆ. ಇದು ಆಗಿದ್ದ ಘಟನೆ.
ದ ಹೋಮ್ ಮಿನಿಸ್ಟರ್ ಟುಡೇ ಜಸ್ಟ್ ದಿಸ್ ಮಾರ್ನಿಂಗ್ ಹಿ ಕೇಮ್ ಔಟ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಸ್ಪೋಕ್ ಟು ದ ಮೀಡಿಯಾ ಸೇಯಿಂಗ್ ದಟ್ ದಿಸ್ ವಾಸ್ ಅ ಕೇಸ್ ಆಫ್ ರೋಡ್ ರೇಜ್ ಕ್ಲಿಯರ್ಲಿ ಅಂಡ್ ದೇ ವೆರಿ ವೆಲ್ ವಾರ್ನ್ಡ್ ಯು ನಾಟ್ ಟು ಗೋ ಬ್ಯಾಕ್ ಟು ದಿ ಏರಿಯಾ. ಸೆಡ್ ದಟ್ ದೇ ವಿಲ್ ಟೇಕ್ ಆಕ್ಷನ್ ಗೋಯಿಂಗ್ ಬೈ ಯುವರ್ ಕಂಪ್ಲೇಂಟ್ ಸೇಯಿಂಗ್ ಯು ಕಂಪ್ಲೇಂಟ್ ಟು ದೆಮ್ ಫಸ್ಟ್ ದಟ್ ದೇ ವಾಸ್ ಇಲೀಗಲ್ ಕೌ ಸ್ಲಾಟರ್ ಹ್ಯಾಪನಿಂಗ್. ದ ಕಾಪ್ ಸೆಡ್ ದೇ ವಿಲ್ ಟೇಕ್ ಆಕ್ಷನ್. ದೇ ಆಲ್ಸೋ ವಾರ್ನ್ಡ್ ಯು ನಾಟ್ ಟು ಗೋ ಬ್ಯಾಕ್ ಟು ದಟ್ ಸ್ಪಾಟ್ ಬಟ್ ಯು ಸ್ಟಿಲ್ ವೆಂಟ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಆಫ್ಟರ್ ಯು ವೆಂಟ್ ವೈಲ್ ಯು ನೋ ಯು ಸಾ ದ ಪ್ಲೇಸ್ ಅಂಡ್ ವೈಲ್ ಯು ವರ್ ಮೂವಿಂಗ್ ಫಾರ್ವರ್ಡ್ ಯು ವರ್ ಟ್ರೈಂಗ್ ಟು you know that was the report given by the police that you were trying to speed off, and while you were speeding off you rammed into a pole and then into an auto. The pole fell to on top of a mutton shop, and that's when you know all of these people were furious and came at you. And when they came at you, you refused to step outside the car, you refused to get off the car, which is why they started pelting stones, and we even understand that a few women pulled you out of the car. Umar,
First and foremost, I would like to say that it is not a twist in the case, because from the day one I am following the news from Logical Indian and Indian Express. I always said there are two versions, although I did not want to disclose what is the next version. Today it's time, it's ripe. The first version is what sister has said, and the second version is that what the commissioner has said now, and that was exactly what DCP Sharanappa said from the day one. There's another version. When that was said, what we did, we sent some people, some media people, to check it out and find out what is the local people trying, what are the local people trying to say. So the local people said exactly what the commissioner said. What the commissioner said today, the local people said, irrespective
and
of
what was that,
they said that the lady happened to visit there earlier. I don't know the exact time. She had come there and she had left that place. That's all they have seen. Some people have seen, but they don't know who she is. So it's a question mark. Some lady is coming and she's going, she's taking some video and she's taking some pictures. And later in the evening again, when it was dark, she has come to that place. And when she was there and taking pictures, some four boys, they have seen that, and one of them has thrown a stone at her on the car. This is the exact version. I'm going to just quote all the references also. Okay, one of them, he has thrown the stone at the, pelted the stone at the car. And immediately she gets panicky and she rushes into the car. She starts the car and she drives it very fast, very unusual manner, because she got scared, and she goes and rams into few things around there. And according to the version there, local version, is an auto, and according to another version, it is the post and
pole.
And post or whatever, and the what do you call, went and it damaged the part of the shop or something, butcher shop or whatever. So this is what I have heard from the local version. Now, evidences should speak for itself. The merit of the case is based on the evidences. If she has got some proofs to say that no, 100 people came and they manhandled me, then that will speak for itself. But now again, she is saying that when they were throwing the stone, she could not, she vaguely could understand what was happening, and she had to run away from that place. So we can't take these kind of statements to be concrete enough to say like what exactly happened. So to say that somebody is running a mafia network there, that in itself is a big statement. You know, mafia is someone controlling the whole thing. But if you happen to go and see there, you find the poor people there who are slaughtering the animals and making their livelihood based on that. Okay, that is their bread and butter.
But it's illegal.
If it is illegal, the papers have to speak for itself. It is for the authorities to check it out. For me, for a person who move around in that area, I cannot say for sure whether it is legal or illegal.
Sir, there is, the only, one, there is only one legal slaughterhouse in the whole of Bangalore,
excuse me,
which is in Tanneri Road.
Let me just
that, that I'm very clear.
Let me finish. See, you whatever you are still an activist. Okay, there are people of authorities. She has got no business in that place. Let me tell it very clearly, without mincing words. She, as a citizen, I can go and complain to the police. If the police is not performing, I can go to the DCP, the higher authority, or I can go to the commissioner and make, or I can go to the human rights or whatever, paperwork. Even if that is not done, lodge a case, take the lawyers. But if you feel there's something going wrong, I cannot go like James Bond and try to do something unless and until I'm equipped with that. And I would not do that. And if you are not capable enough, you should not be there. And I don't understand the mindset of the so-called animal rights people. I don't understand. If you're really caring for animals, then first thing you should be worried about chicken stall. Yes, animals.
Well, I think we're deviating from that. That's still a deviation.
What I'm trying to say is there are many chicken shops there.
Ultimately,
there are many chicken shops there.
I'm sorry, sir. That is not that is legal as per our country's laws. It is legal. So we don't go after things.
Animal rights. If you're talking about animal rights.
Yes.
Legal and illegal again. It is for not for you and me. It
is
for the authorities.
It is for me.
For the authorities to surely confirm. We can't confirm it.
I understand what is legal and what is not legal, and I go after the legal.
Other day, the advocate was very clearly saying that it is absolutely legal to slaughter the cattle in Karnataka. The other day, the advocate who was here,
Mr. Dhananjay,
see, again, she's saying the Supreme Court lawyer is wrong. She's saying the Supreme Court lawyer is wrong, but I'm saying
he,
I have...
He's a tax lawyer, sir. What does he know about cattle laws?
Now again, you are contesting with the people of law.
Hey,
that is a big...
No way.
In spite of running away... ma'am, I will notice, no, if I have an accident with the auto. I don't agree with the sir's statements that, she didn't even know. If I hit a khamba, I said, no, I hit a khamba in the
process.
In your
FIR that you filed, have you written there that you've hit a khamba?
No, that I did not write. But I have been never denied it. Times Now interviewed me on day one and I said in the process I have hit a khamba. On day one only I have said. I have not hidden that as a fact. It is not a new fact which has come out. You can see the Times Now footage.
Did you forget to mention it in the FIR or was it a conscious...
No,
it was not important? Is there an auto that they can... Omar, you said that
I've seen one picture. In fact, the picture where an auto was fallen down, and that picture was sent to me, and I've got that picture also. I've also sent to most of the media people, including to members of TV9.
But Nandini has no recollection of an auto being there at all.
I can't say what is fact.
Of course.
I can only say what has come to me.
I have not hit any auto, madam.
So there was no auto there.
In my path, there was no auto which I have hit. Let me say that.
I got a suggestion. You don't have to do much. Just take the cameras, go and interview the public there. Let us not take the police version. Let us not. We need witness, isn't it? And who can be better than the people around there? Irrespective of caste and whichever religion or whichever walks of life they are coming from. Let's go and do a thorough investigation from the public. Public will not go wrong. Even if you are hearing to two contradictory versions, at the end of the day, evidences cannot go wrong. The proofs will speak for itself.
I agree with him.
Yeah.
I agree with Mr. Umar Shariff. Question is what? If at all the accident has taken place, now the question arises. You have to dissect. I'm a journalist. You are a journalist. Did the accident took place after she was mobbed under pelted her stones, and did the accident took place while she was returning to escape from the murderous attack? Or did the mob was she attacked when she went and to take some evidence of the slaughterhouse's
engine. I did not step out of the car, sir. As soon as I reached the dead end, I was attacked.
So that means...
At the end of the day, there is something wrong. We cannot say that...
Of course, something is wrong.
whatever I can gather here, all of the facts presented by her side and the police side for that matter, may the facts are possibly true, but the chronological order is jumbled up.
Yes, it's mixed up.
So, ma'am, was she attacked because she took a video, or was she taking, because she was taking a picture, or because she was spying on that illegal slaughterhouse, or because she saw that was going back, ramped into something, and then they got an opportunity to vent their anger, which they already had on you.
But the mistake that Nandini has done is not mentioning that
in her FIR, saying that she rammed into something.
But still, ma'am, it's a fact that you can't miss out from an FIR.
That's crucial. Now, that aside, more or less, if you really add two and two together, it seems like any which way the mob must have been angry with the fact that you were trying to put your nose in when it was not your business, apparently. But then they had no choice but to, they couldn't do much but to keep quiet until you actually were driving back and hit into an auto or almost knocked off a pole. That's when they had a chance to attack you, and all of that anger and that frustration they showed right at that time, because they had the chance to. And that aside, there's no CCTV cameras there?
Very difficult. In that area, I don't think so.
No, I don't think so. The whole question, let me tell you.
See, I have known that place because people keep frequenting there. And I'm told almost every Eid, Bakrid, there is slaughtering of the oxen, and it regularly happens. Mm. It is not something which is started from last year or previous year. It is their way of life. Since years, since decades, or maybe it could have been even before that. Mm. So now to educate them, if at all you say it is illegal, for them to get educated, what is illegal? Mm. What kind of slaughtering is illegal? Sir, exactly. Today the problem is...
The point that you made is absolutely right. People are not educated about See, it. And for them, it's more like attacking their religion than attacking their business.
So for me, it's more like that. So for me to say...
So they are not educated, and they are furious because they think it's going to cut off their bread and butter, ultimately.
I will tell you one thing. There is a problem in our system.
Yes.
We cannot deny it. The way that sister is saying that she had to wait for hours together to lodge a complaint.
Imagine she's had her injuries.
This
and
is the norm.
Standing in the police station for 4 hours.
This is the norm, actually.
This is the norm today.
This is the norm.
Yeah, they purposely, because they demotivate you so that you don't run after it, and then the case will close by itself naturally, so that you don't pursue it. There's more headache for them.
One of my friends was asked by a lady sub-inspector. I don't want to bring the case here because it is in the court. I don't want to put in it. Gotta nimge eskarsa agutte anta to come out of this case. Do you know how much you have to spend? You have to spend 10. I said 10,000. My friend said 10,000. Hey, 10,000 alla re 10 laksha kharcha agutte. The moment you say that, I hesitate to go.
Exactly. These are tactics. But I'd like to ask, the cops also pinpointed at the fact, they also raised doubts on your injuries. They said that, for all you know, you could be faking it, one. Number two, that the mob did not attack you. It was just your injuries were as a result of the accident, therefore stone pelting. It was nobody touched you and whatnot. It's unfortunate that you're fighting your battle alone when you actually had another person in the car. He could have been great witness, at least for the fact that you're speaking with the media. He should come forward and testify for you.
Yeah, that's very important.
Hmm. I'm getting.
When did the incident take place?
On Saturday night.
Date?
Saturday night.
Date.
14th, I think.
14th. So you've done your first medical checkup at...
independently, because the police have done their...
Yeah, you've done your first medical checkup independently, as in it says Cochin, but here in your report.
No, the other one is the Bangalore one,
Cochin,
madam.
But that is on the 18th. So your first instance, you've done it privately with the hands
there
of...
Was a
but even if you did an X-ray, you did it almost 4-5 days after the incident. You should have done it... earlier, so that you would have had a better standing in your own case.
The next hour is what they are supposed
to do. I wish I would have done it, madam, but things were just, it was like a whirlwind. Next day I didn't even know where I was, how I was in a state of shock. and the pain was there.
Badly was for you to go and actually get it checked. And I'm actually surprised that a private, a doctor all the way flew down from Cochin only for this. And that's amazing.
See, this is actually, let me be very frank. See, this is actually inconsistent with what is expected. Because the first thing what the police would expect is the proof from the doctor, government hospital certificate. That is within an hour is what they expect generally.
This is four days later.
So 4 days later is raising many questions because it's supposed to be within an hour, sir.
I mean, no doubt that our cops have also failed, but definitely.
Why didn't they do
no,
it?
No, as you are a person who's complaining.
See,
you
we
are
obviously blaming the system here, Nandini, but definitely something that you've missed out on as well, no doubt. 4 days of a delay, I'm sure Hemant would be able to guide you on that.
It has to be done
immediately,
as early as possible, if not immediately.
The MLC was done immediately.
When?
On the night, by the police, but they didn't take an X-ray.
Where is the MLC report then? See, it should have been done in a... See,
MLC
the norm is we have to get it done in a government hospital because government hospitals work 24/7.
Me to do all these things.
Do you have that report with you?
Not with me. Should you have it?
No, I'll have to go and get it, but they have made the minor injuries report in the FIR basis the MLC.
That see, Nandini, I hope you realize that when you're fighting a case and when you're now you know that you're fighting the police department on the whole or the government for that fact on the whole, you need to have your standing strong. And as much as possible, we will back you, no doubt, if you're honest. But the point is, you need to have all of this in place. No matter
Nabila,
how much we talk or debate here,
Nabila, it won't matter
tomorrow unless and until you have your proof and document.
Nabila, I agree.
There's two things to say. See, even if one has to go to the court of law, at the end of the day, papers have to speak or evidence should speak. So the person who had accompanied or the people who were there or some of the facts which she can, tangible evidences, one thing. Secondly, to define anything as illegal, as sister is saying, she's saying the only legal slaughterhouse is in Tandri Road. But I am a witness. Shivajinagar, Cookstown, you come to Banashankari, there are n number of slaughterhouses which are working and people know, and the customers are from all communities. I have personally interviewed a Christian. And
no, I mean that's somehow been the culture,
it's
you
in
know,
the culture.
For as long. But now there should be a clampdown on illegal houses. For a clampdown to happen, exactly. Let them define what is illegal.
We need to raise on this topic as to what is legal and
illegal. It is not
that easy. This issue.
It is not that easy.
Because everything is happening almost in every area.
Right.
Yeah.
So she was passing by. She saw some animals. How did you come to a conclusion that is unauthorized? Do you have any paper workout? Have you worked out on the paper?
Sir, let me tell you one thing.
My question is very simple.
Let me tell you one thing.
Saying that there's only one designated. You're saying multiple.
Impossible.
It is, sir.
It is impossible.
It is not impossible.
Even the advocates are saying that it is not that way to say that all of these things are illegal.
Sir,
it is not that way. If it was so,
advocate is saying that.
There are hundreds of
slaughterhouses. No advocate is saying this, sir. Who is educated on the cattle
laws? How many advocates we have met? The other day, there was a Mr. Dhananjay who was here.
Mr. Dhananjay is a tax lawyer, sir. He doesn't know about the cattle laws.
So you say that he doesn't know the law.
Being an animal
you are saying that he doesn't. See, the thing is, you are totally contesting the person who is studying law.
Okay, anyway, we're not debating on who is a good lawyer and who is not, and who is relevant and who is not. But
the question is, how did you come to a conclusion?
Let me ask you another question. He said there are multiple slaughterhouses all over the place, not just where you mentioned. Why not there? You could have gone and made many complaints across of Bangalore city. I will show you how many are there.
Shivajinagar, you will find many.
They're all over the place.
Authorized?
We don't know.
I haven't checked the papers.
They're legal or not.
So
she's
saying there's only one in the whole of the.
Honestly, there is. Don't you know? There's slaughterhouses everywhere. You say, but we don't know which is illegal, which is not
how
illegal.
How do we come to conclusion?
There's no definition.
The issue was in the High Court.
All of that is fine, but my point is, why only Talgatta Pura that you
I was
saw?
Going.
You
were, I was not going there with
the
intention.
You worked on your impulse. No, it was on your impulse.
Yeah.
Quickly.
Yeah. What I want her to do is to find out the exact definition of what is authorized and unauthorized, and legal and illegal.
Okay.
Then she has to move ahead.
Right.